Hello, this is Josh from BigPanda. Welcome to the Getting Started with Changes in RCC video. In this video, we'll discuss how to integrate change data to drive powerful root cause analysis. We call this feature Root Cause Changes, or RCC for short. Specifically, we're going to discuss changes and the challenges they present, discuss the solution to this challenge, BigPanda's Root Cause Changes feature, go over the different types of change tools BigPanda can integrate with, go over the different types of change integrations in BigPanda, and demonstrate an integration with a change tool from start to end. Let's start by discussing what are changes. Modern infrastructure and apps generate a lot of noise, and by definition and design, they're also changing constantly. The deployment of a new version of a microservice, a new network configuration, or a new permission policy to a database. All of these and more are all changes, and they cause over 85% of today's IT incidents and outages. These changes are tracked by many siloed tools, and with often thousands of changes happening every day, it has become extremely difficult to identify the offending change in a change-related outage. This is where the BigPanda Root Cause Changes feature, or RCC, comes in. RCC presents you with all the changes related to the incidents you are working on, and notifies you which of these changes are suspected to be the root cause. Let's see how that works. In BigPanda, when we click on the Changes tab of an incident, we can see a consolidated view of all the changes from all change tools that are related to that incident. The changes that are shown are those that occurred in a time frame before the start of the incident. And this time frame is configurable. BigPanda leverages open box machine learning to mark the changes it suspects are those that cause the incident. This allows operators to understand potential root cause, to mitigate issues before they escalate, and to reduce MTTR. Similar to alerts, change events have key value attributes. All change events have a status, an identifier key, and a summary. Suspect changes also show the reason why BigPanda's open box machine learning has chosen them as such. Marking a suspect change as a match provides feedback to the machine learning algorithm for improvement, as well as sharing a comment with your team for further collaboration. Now let's discuss the different types of change tools that you may be using and integrating with BigPanda. Traditional ITSM tools are typically used for managed changes and planned releases. Jira, ServiceNow, and Remedy are all examples. DevOps CI/CD tools like Jenkins, GitHub, and GitLab are all used for agile development to help automate the building, testing, and deployment of applications. Dynamic infrastructure tools such as CloudTrail, Ansible, and Terraform are used to automate or track changes to cloud environments. All of these types of tools may be used simultaneously with BigPanda, and their combined data helps provide context to the incident management process and root cause analysis. In BigPanda, there are two types of integrations. The first is out-of-the-box. Out-of-the-box integrations leverage the respective change tool's built-in ability to push directly over HTTPS, typically through a webhook. To make them out-of-the-box and easy, BigPanda pre-compiled the receiving endpoints to properly parse and normalize the change payloads, and also vetted the steps required to configure the forwarding of changes. If your change source is supported by one of the out-of-the-box integrations, we recommend you use them to get started quickly. For all other change tools, including homegrown and custom ones, BigPanda's scalable and easy-to-use REST API can also be used. Now that we've learned about the different change tools and BigPanda integrations, I'm going to change gears and go into the Open Integration Hub in BigPanda's UI and integrate a change tool. Specifically, we'll be showing a ServiceNow change integration, but the principles are the same for any tool you choose. Let's go to the Integrations menu. To start a new integration, simply click New Integration, and you'll be presented with all of our available out-of-the-box integrations. The tabs at the top we'll filter the integrations by monitoring, collaboration, and changes. For the purpose of this video, we will stay in the Changes tab and click ServiceNow Changes for step-by-step instructions. We will now create the ServiceNow change integration. The first step is to give the integration a name and generate a unique integration app key. Let's copy and save this app key for later use in a text file, which we created prior to the configuration. In this file, we also saved the bearer token. This is a unique token that identifies your BigPanda instance. If you do not have your bearer token, you can access it by viewing one of your existing alert integrations. And the API key. The API key allows you to securely authenticate calls to the BigPanda public API. The API key is created by accessing the API key management page. Let's paste the integration app key. Let's go back to BigPanda. The next step is to install the BigPanda application in your ServiceNow instance. To access the ServiceNow app, click here. Next, simply select Download to install BigPanda into your ServiceNow environment. Once the app is installed, we can access it from our ServiceNow instance by searching for BigPanda. The BigPanda app contains three separate modules, one for incident integration, one for change integration, and another for CMDB integration. In this video, we are focusing on the change integration. To configure ServiceNow to work with our BigPanda instance, we select Configuration. Now return to the text file and copy and paste the bearer token, the integration app key, and the API key. We will enable the change integration by checking the active box. You have the option to customize some of the default values for incidents when they are created, but for the purpose of this demo, let's go with the default settings. Next, press Submit, and that's it. To test the change integration, let's go back to BigPanda. We've created a new change in ServiceNow and made note of its start time, which was 3:12 p.m. We've also created an incident in BigPanda from alerts with a later timestamp at 3:16 p.m., which you can see in the preview pane. Now, let's click on the Changes tab of this incident and look for our change from 3:12. Here it is. Let's click on it to verify that the fields were processed correctly. A link to ServiceNow is also available, where we can go back to the original change and its data. Now that you're familiar with changes and BigPanda root cause changes, continue to the next videos to dive deeper into additional topics. We want you to be successful in your BigPanda journey. So if at any point you need help, please reach out to our support team via the in-app chat. And don't forget about our online documentation at docs.bigpanda.io. Thank you for watching.